Hello friends, so in this session we will see this topic, valence shell electron pair theory. In short, we used to write VSEPR theory. So what is this theory? According to if you have gone through the previous session, in this we have discussed this about the concept of Lewis-Langevin on covalent bonding. So in this theory he was unable to explain the shapes of covalent bonding of molecules. So if in covalent molecules, if there are three or more atoms in which one atom will act as a central atom and rest atoms are linked to it to give the definite direction space. Why they can give their definite directions? Because the covalent bonds are directional in nature, that we already know. So as a result of this, atoms constituting the molecules, they will occupy the definite positions with respect to another. And this definite relative arrangement of these bonded atoms in the molecules is actually called as geometry of molecules. So this space model which contains by joining the, when the space model which is obtained by joining the points representing the various bonded atoms will describe the shape of molecules. But both geometry of molecules and shapes of molecules are different. So this will give only bonded atoms, but this will give even the bonded atoms as well as lone pair of atoms. We will see how both molecules shapes are different. So once we know the geometry of molecule, we can able to measure the bond distance and bond angle. So this is the one application of this by knowing the geometry and shapes of the molecule. Let us see what is VSEPR theory. And this theory was proposed to predict the shape and geometry of covalent molecules, and first proposed by Sidgwick and Powell, then it was further developed by the Gillespie and Nilam. So what is this theory? It is based on the fact that in a polyatomic molecule, the direction bonds around the central atom, it depends upon the total number of electron pairs. So electron pairs may be bonding as well as non-bonding in its valence shell. These electron pairs then what happens? They will themselves, as far as apart from possible in space, and in order to have the minimum force of repulsion between them, so they have the minimum force of repulsion, so they will orient in themselves so that they will have this repulsion, and this minimum repulsion, it will corresponds to state of minimum energy and maximum stability of molecule. Okay, so what is the main postulates? Main postulate means let us see that. And the slope of the molecule, it depends upon the number of valence shell electron molecules. Shape of molecules, it will depend upon the number of valence electron pair. So valence electron may be bond pair or lone pair, means bonded non-pair around the central atom. And we have to consider this one important point. Double or triple bonds is also considered as the single bond in determining the geometry of molecule. This is also important point in this postulates. Second point, the electron pairs in valence shell, they will repel each other. Why? Because they are negatively charged. Position of the electron pair. Electron pair, we discussed that it may be bond pair or lone pair. So in space, it will around the central atoms are such that, they will orient in such that, they will gain the minimum repulsion and maximum distance between them. Means, this lone pair, in the space, they will occupy more space. Why? Because they are bigger in size than the bond pair. So definitely it will give maximum repulsion than the bond pair. Next is the magnitude of the different type of electronic repulsions. They follows the order, this one, lone pair, bond, lone pair, bond pair, bond pair, bond pair. So lone pair will give you maximum repulsion. Lone pair, bond pair will give you less repulsion. You can see electrons will be closer to Y, and bond pair will be very, very less repulsion. So electrons are almost closer to each other because it depends upon the electronegativity, depends upon the central atom of the central atom and other atoms. So this repulsive forces between this lone pair, bond pair, or bond pair, it actually it changes the bond angle of the molecules, or it will slightly distort the bond angle from the ideal shape. This lone pair, it will distort the angle. So we'll see how lone pair distort the shape of the molecules, how lone pair is causing the repulsive forces. We'll come through an example one by one. Let us complete the postulate first. Electronic repulsion between the two pairs of electrons should be minimum, so if they are as far as possible. Let us see, if number of pairs means electron pairs are 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If suppose all are bond pair, means 2 bond pair, 3 bond pair, 4 bond pair, 5 bond pair, 6 bond pair. So a geometric figure will be, for this case, linear, for this case, triangular, planar, for this case, tetrahedral, and for this case, triangular, bipyramidal, and for this case, octahedral. You can see BCl2, CO2, general Cl2, they are linear molecules, while BCl3, SO3, carbonate, they are planar. While tetrahedral, CH4, H3O plus, NH4 plus, PF5, SBSL5, this is the 5, triangular, bipyramidal, and SF6, IF5, SI, F2, this one, 2 negative. So, these are the octahedral in nature. So, let us give you one picture to understand. You can see the picture of linear molecules. This is the linear molecules, which is the 180 degree. So, we can see example BCl2, HgCl2, Cl2. And this is the trigonal planar. You can see BCl4, AlCl3, BF3. So, this molecule don't have the lone pair. They do not have lone pair. Similarly, we have tetrahedral. So, in tetrahedral, you can see this is the tetrahedral structure. So, bond angle is also given properly. So, all bond angles are 109. You can see there are 6 bond angles. So, this is 1 angle, 2 angle, 3 angle, 4 angle, and 1 with this angle, 5, and 1 with this angle, 6. With and this, these 3. So, 1, 3, 1, 3. So, total 6, 109.5 degree angles are present in tetrahedral with these molecules. Similarly, we can see this one, trigonal bipyramidal. So, you can see structures. So, it is diagonal bipyramidal, PF5, SBCl5, PCl5. So, this is at the axial bonds, this is at the equatorial bonds. The equatorial bonds, this will give you maximum repulsion, 120 degree angle, and this is 90 degree angle. So, there are 3 equatorial bonds and 2 axial bonds. So, axial bonds are having the maximum repulsion than the equatorial bonds. So, like this in there. So, definitely this bond length will be more than that, this one. So, bond length in axial is more than that of equatorial. And if you see this one, SF6, this is octahedral. Example, this is. So, this is 4 are in plane and 2 is in axial bonds. So, this is more repulsion is there. So, definitely all bonds angles will be different. This is equatorial bonds, this is the axial bond. Definitely axial bonds will be longer than the equatorial bonds. So, you can see this diagram. So, this is called as the octahedral. Now, let us see the next point. If the central atom is linked to similar atoms and is surrounded by only the bond pair of electrons, the repulsion between them are similar. As a result, shape of the molecules symmetrical or molecules having a regular geometry that we have seen in the examples. How the BCl3 having the regular geometry, SF6 having regular geometry because of this repulsion only. Like CO2, linear structures, SO3, planar structures. On the other hand, molecules which have the repulsive interaction between the electron pairs around the central atom, so they are unequal. So, they have the regular geometry or distorted geometry. So, these are the examples, lone pair, ammonia, water. So, they have one lone pair. So, angle is not 109. It will be 106.5 degree. While in case of water, it will be 104 degree. CH4 will be purely tetrahedral because it don't have a lone pair. While the ammonia and water have a pyramidal structure, water having the angular structure, they have distorted geometry despite of 2 bond pair and 2 lone pair. So, ammonia having a 3 bond pair, 1 lone pair, water having 2 bond pair and 2 lone pair. A multiple bond, next point is having a double triple bond, they are considered a single super pair. So, this we already discussed. For example, we have taken xenon oxide, so we have 4 bonds, but they will assume as a tetrahedral structure. They don't have lone pair. So, double bond is more repulsion, just note it down. Double bonds having the more repulsion than single bond, and triple bond also cause more repulsion than double bond. Means, double bond is, triple bond is more repulsive than double bond followed by single bond. So, this is the repulsive forces you have to keep in mind. Next point, where two or more resonance structures can represent a molecule, then VSEPR model is applicable to any such structure. Let us see the strategy for applying the VSEPR method. So, it will predict the shape of molecules or polyatomic ions. Following steps are followed. Step 1, first you draw the Lewis structure of the molecule of a polyatomic ion. For example, ammonia written as this Lewis structures, and for ammonia this is. Step 2, determine the number of electron groups around the central atom. So, central atom, how many electron groups are there, bonding and non-bonding both. a double bond, triple bond each in counter electron group. So we can see in this case, so how many hydrogens are there? 3 hydrogen, 3 bond pair and 1 lone pair. So we will arrange like a Lewis structures. Then identify the electron group geometry. It can be linear, triangular, planar, tetrahedral, diagonal, bipyramidal, or octahedral, corresponding to, if this is linear, so there will be 2 bond pair. If this is a triangular planar, there will be 3, tetrahedral 4, triangular bipyramidal will be 5, and octahedral will be 6 respectively. And then identify the molecular geometry, and this will be this is based on the position around the central atom and occupied by other atoms, not by lone pairs. Let us see this all rules in examples. So this is the molecular geometry around atoms with 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 charge clouds. Total number of electrons, pairs and bonding and non-bonding. So number of bonds are there. Number of lone pairs are there. 2, 0. This is the total number of charge, 2, 0. So it has no lone pairs, so 2. And VSEPR notation is AX2. And molecular geometry, this one, linear. So when you are taking 2 bonds, it will be linear. Maximum person 180 degree, example this one. When you have 3 bond pair, no lone pair, so you have a regular geometry is AX3, triangular planar, you can see it is planar, so BF3. But if you have 1 lone pair, 2 plus 1, 3, but charge is 3, so it will have AX2E. So 1 lone pair will go at equator, so equator lone pair will occupy maximum space, as we discuss one of the point. The structure will be like this. Little bit will go further, so when you have 4 bond pair, no lone pair, AX is regular geometry, this is regular geometry, you will get this geometry, this is ideal geometry of molecule CH4. But if you have 1 lone pair, 3 plus 1, total charge is 4. Then you have trigonal, pyramidal, then a geometry will be, so instead of writing here, it will be you have to write lone pair. So this will pull more upward, so this bond angle will shift downward. So it will decrease to 106.5 degree. Now this is not a regular geometry, this is the shape of the molecule, which is pyramidal. If you take 2 plus 2, so 2 plus 2 means 2 lone pair, 2 bond pair. So geometry just form like ideal geometry, one is at the equator, one is at the axial. So this will cause a maximum repulsion, so it will undergo like a bent structure. So lone pair repulsion is more, so this bond angle is becomes more smaller. This is 104 degree for this one water molecule. Now if you take 5 bond pair, no lone pair, structure is regular geometry, 3 is at equatorial plane and 2 will be at your 90 degree plane. So this structure is trigonal bipyramidal. They will arrange like this one. If you take 4 plus 1, charge is 5. So 1 means 1 lone pair is there. So lone pair will first occupy the equatorial position. 2 will be in equatorial, or 1 will be at the axial position. But if you take 2 lone pair, so 2 will be again, they will occupy the equatorial plane, because this equatorial plane, the molecule is more stable. So you can see, this is the 2 bond pair, and at the axial position, one is the one. So we cannot write like this structures, this lone pair, one lone pair, this one. This will be your unstable structure. We can write, but this two-way structure will be unstable. Means if you take a lone pair opposite up-down, so this structure unstable, this structure unstable. This is more stable structure, T-shaped structure. So this is the shape of the molecule. Suppose you have 2 bond pair and 3 lone pair, then the molecule will be again linear. So this 3 will be again occupying the your equatorial position first, because this will cause the less repulsion. So you will have structure, linear structure there, because contribution of the lone pair is not found in the this one geometry in the molecule. Now if you take the 6 bond pair, no lone pair, so structure will be octahedral, so 4 will be at plane and 2 will be at axial position. 5 plus 1, 6 again, 1 lone pair is there, so 1 lone pair will occupy here. So this is some exceptional structure, we cannot put over here. So this is again exceptional, because this is occupying the your axial position for the stability. And again you can find out the angle between this CL at axial position, SB and CL is not 90 degree. It will be less than 90 degree because of lone pair will having the maximum repulsion with bond pair. So it will come upward and this bond will decrease. So it will having the bond angle less than 90 degree. Now 4 bond pair, 2 lone pair. So again they are occupying the axial position. So it will having the square planar. So this will be almost a square planar structures. These two are exception to this lone pair this one shape theory, because lone pair occupying the maximum space at equatorial, but in case of this element, they are not occupying this at the equatorial position, rather they are occupying at the axial position for its stability. So you can see this is the VSEPR geometry. So this is 0 lone pair, 1 lone pair, 2 lone pair, 3 lone pair, 4 lone pair. So this is a structure, 4 linear. These are trigonal planars. So if you take 1 lone pair, you will get this structure bent or angular. Or in this you can see for 0 lone pair, tetrahedral. This is the trigonal bipyramidal and this is the bent or angular. And if you take this is a trigonal bipyramidal in this structure, you can see this is the sawhorse structures. Sawhorse structure, this is a T shape, this is a linear one horse. So you can see this is a lone pair occupying the equatorial position. And if you take this one, they are the six bond pair, no lone pair. If you take one lone pair, it will occupy the equatorial position. If you take two lone pair, again axial position. And if you take three lone pair, then they will occupy the equatorial position. So for one lone pair, two lone pairs, they are not occupying the equatorial, but three and four, they are occupying the this one equatorial position. So where the there is a maximum stability of the molecule. So these are the exception to VSEPR theory. So I have another diagram. So we can see the number of structural pairs for two bond. You can see in terms of orbital diagram also, it is very convenient to understand. Diagonal planar will be this structure. See the orbital diagram. For tetrahedral, see the orbital diagram. For trigonal bipyramidal, this is a diagram. So 90 degree, this is the 120 degree. On octahedral, this is the structure and this is the angle. If you see in terms of electron pair geometry, you can see tetrahedral, trigonal bipyramidal. In case of tetrahedral, this is the ammonia, this is the NH3 bond angle. You can see, if you see the bent structure of water molecule, 104.5 degrees. So angle has been this one. So this is decreasing. If you increase the lone pair, a structure is being changed. So now if you take the 5 electron trigonal bipyramidal, so 5 electron pair, so electron pair geometry will be this one. It is very clear. So for trigonal pyramidal, you can see this is a PF5, 5 bond pair, no lone pair. This is the 4 bond pair, 1 lone pair. See our structure, how they are occupying the spaces. And for T shape, this is structure CLF3, 3 bond pair and 2 lone pair. In this structure, you can see 2 bond pair and 3 lone pair. Similarly, if you see in 6 electron pair, the geometry is octahedral. So this is a regular geometry. These are the shapes of the molecule in which one lone pair is down, one, two lone pairs are outside. If you take three lone pair, it will go to the equatorial plane. So I hope you have understood the shapes and geometry of the molecule by using the VSEPR theory. Now we'll see the variation of bond angle around the central atom. So if the molecule is having the similar geometry, like BF3, AlCl3, the bond angle around the central atoms decreases as its electronegativity decreases. Then the electron pair around the central atoms will lie farther away from it. The repulsive interaction between the electron pair, it will decrease. Why? Because bond angles are decreases around the central atom. Let's take example like H2O, H2O, this is a group 16 element. So these are the hydrides of group 16, H2O, H2OS, H2SC, selenium, H2. So size of the central atom is increasing. So definitely bond angle will also decrease. See how it is decreasing. Similarly, if you take the group 15 hydrides of group 15 elements, NH3, PS3, ASS3, BiS3. So again, bond angles are decreasing. Why? Because the size of the central atom is increasing. That's why the repulsive interaction between the electron will also decrease, causing the bond angle decline. So bond angle means this, there will be more repulsive forces. Okay, there is more less repulsive between the bonded atoms. Therefore, this will decrease when you size of the oxygen also increasing. Means size of central atom increases, electronegativity decreases, and bond pair is away from the central atoms. So this bond pair is away from the central atoms and bond angle decreases. It becomes your bent shapes. Second point is that if the electronegativity of surrounding atoms decreases, if the electronegativity decreases, then electron pairs lie closer to central atom and therefore the bond angle would increase. So this is the, so you can see PF3, PCl3, PBr3, PI3. So P is central atom, but fluorine, iodine. So here atom size of the this side atoms are increasing. So bond angles also increases. You can see, so fluorine more electronegative, so bond pair will be more attracted towards the fluorine. In these cases, bond pair will be more attracted towards, but in cases it will be more attracted towards the phosphorus, so bond angle will increase. So bond angle of, similarly we can explain, bond angle of F2O is lesser than that of H2O. I hope that you have understood. O is the central atom, fluorine more electronegative, so bond angle will be lesser. And for in case of water, bond angle more, because electron pairs are more attracted towards the oxygen. Electron pairs is of the iodine is more attracted towards the phosphorus, while it is more attracted towards the fluorine. That's why all having the pyramidal shape, but the bond angle will decrease. In case of regular geometry, bond angle around the central atom does not change with the variation of electronegativity of the central atoms, or you can say surrounding atoms. For example, BF3, BCl3, BBr3, AlCl3. So all they have the bond angle is 120 degrees. In case of CH4, CCl4, CBr4, they have symmetry. So they have regular geometry of 109.28 degrees. Now see one important, what are the limitation of VSEPR theory? This is the important point. So VSEPR3 unable to explain number of cases. So some of the cases are there. It fails to explain the isoelectronic spaces like IF7 and F, this is TEF7 whole minus. So both are 56 electrons. These are not coplanar. They have different shape if they have a same number of electrons. Similarly, you can take the water and HF. So they are also electronic. Isoelectronic means they have 10 electrons each, but H2O is bent while this is linear. It also does not explain the transition metal compounds. Why? Because it does not take the associated size of the substituent and inactive lone pairs into the account. For example, SCCL, this one, TECL6, 2 negative, BRFC negative. They should adopt the shape of pentagonal bipyramidal geometries as the central atom have the same electron pairs. But you see, TECL6, different geometry, this is octahedral, and this is your square pyramidal. You can see in case of F is this side, so it is a pentagonal pyramidal. It is not a bipyramidal. Why? Because of, due to stereochemical inert pair effect, this is one factor, and these molecules have regular octahedral, but one of the electron pair is stereochemically inactive. So one chemical pair is stereochemically inactive. That's why it is not associating the size of the substituent and lone pair, inactive lone pair. So lone pairs are also inactive. Even you can take XCFA2 negative, it will show the structure of anti-prismatic. This is the structure. Again, same thing, stereochemical inert pair effect is there. So inert pair means lone pairs are inert, they are not contributing the structure. That's why they are getting this type of structures. Next point is, it does not tell the direction of electron pair. So BS2, as per VSEPR, this is a linear structure. So B is there, how linear structure? So it should be, actually, if you see the beryllium, it is assuming the shape of 2s2, so it should be a spherical direction, it is spherical, so it is non-directional. Structure of beryllium should be non-directional because it has s orbital. So how can you describe the two bonds arranged at 180 degrees from the orbital description? Because we must then to understand this thing, it should have a spherical but it has a linear. Why is linear? We should understand a new this concept by a new concept that is called of orbital, that is called hybridization. So we will now see what is hybridization, how it is defining the geometry of a molecules, because some of the concept is not defined by the VSEPR theory.